Hi, morning. Here I am, Richardless. So while he's working in the States, Jerry Springer's working here all week till Richard gets back.
Okay, he's a member of the most successful boy band ever, but Boyzone's Mikey Graham feels he's always been in the background. Now it's his turn to take the spotlight.
Another one going solo.
There you go, yeah.
And Kevin was on last week, and he's actually put his out the same day.
Stephen.
What am I talking about, Stephen?
Yeah, coincidentally, it's landed on the same day, which is this day next week, Monday the 29th. Yeah.
So, but you guys are still all together.
Yeah, absolutely. We've been working hard about the last six, 7 years. We just felt we need to kind of branch out a bit and do some new things. And
good for you.
So your music's totally different from Boyzone, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Is that the kind of thing you actually prefer to play?
I suppose personally it is. Boyzone, well, the music of Boyzone is a collaboration really of the five different tastes in music brought together. But individually we have, massive different tastes, and this is mine.
Now, Boyzone's, when you started out, your audience was primarily young teens, screaming 13 and 14 year old girls.
Yeah.
You're getting older. You've been around, 7 years already?
Yeah, well, the audience has definitely matured, and I think we've been lucky enough to kind of branch into an older audience than that again, the whole adult audience, if you like,
And that's what you're interested in doing with this, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
But if a 14-year-old wants to scream,
well,
that's okay.
It, yeah. I mean, yeah. I would never try to eliminate the younger audience, but I think the sound is probably more appealing to a slightly older audience.
Yeah.
So basically, I mean, creatively, you feel you're getting the best of both worlds. I mean, you're still with this hugely successful band, but you're getting the chance to indulge your own private musical taste as well.
Show them what I can do.
And who are you?
This is Howard New here.
Hello.
Graham Kearns.
Are you Irish too?
English. So we're going to do an acoustic version of the song, which is also available on this format.
And it's called You're My Angel, and it's about your daughter, isn't it?
Yeah, well, primarily she was the influence or the inspiration behind the song, but rather than being too self-indulgent lyrically, I try to create a universal or general meaning to the song so everybody can relate to it,
How old is she?
She's 4 years of age.
Okay. Right. Well, thank you very much. And that's almost it today, apart from Mikey. You enjoyed it?
I had a great time.
It was great.
Richard hasn't called you, has he?
He's called me four times. In fact, he's called me every single day.
Yeah, notice how he never calls you at night.
Because he's in LA.
Oh, yeah, that's the old LA thing, right.
Tomorrow we have the girls from All Saints on their movie debut, and a former model who feels frumpy at 50 gets a makeover from Nikki and Lee.
Plus, Martin Shaw in Live. And with a new report finding that suicide among teenage boys is rising alarmingly, our phone-ins on Cries for Help with Raj Purcell.
But we'll leave you now with Mikey's debut solo single, You're My Angel. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching.
Bye, everybody. Thank you.
Found my way from the darkness after all this time, and now I see your smiling face looking back at mine. I was always told that love can be blind, but now I understand that love can be kind, 'cause you're my angel. Gotta make you see I'm the one for you. You're the one for me, 'cause you're my angel. Gotta let you know, now I found you. I'm never letting go, 'cause you're my angel. Sometimes I'm empty, I'm weak or in the spirit. It's enough to know that you are always there. And I love you 'cause you can see inside. Never letting go, 'cause you're my angel.